gonna try to break some links free today and work on some more down here. So. Plug it in. Pretty much, I wanted to open up all the links. Here, they're alternating. So now I can flip it. Picking and poking and flipping. Be careful when you're pulling those where the two links come together. In these areas, there's going to be a lot of big loose chunks. That's where your saw will tend to jump. So you just take your time there. now you see we're starting to actually cut in. Bevel in for our roundness of the insides of our links. Just a little bit at a time. I'm kind of carving a little bit fast in a hurry. Because my back hurts. Start moving quick and a little bit hurried. You see pieces, big chunks are bouncing around, flying all over. That's where you guys, you know, if you haven't tried this before, take your time. Because they will hurt. If they hit you, they'll hurt you. If they allow the saw to jump really bad, you could get hurt really bad. So just take your time, feel it. Feel that chunk breaking loose with the tip of the saw before you let it fly out. I'm kind of going quick. I know where my limits are. So that's the thing, is if you don't know it's coming, be very gentle. Take your time with this. The other, you can get these links almost perfect if you actually use a tape measure, if you use a string line. I mean, you can really get involved with making them real clean and perfect. The ideal thing to do would be to cut the logs down to a big square beam first and then start. Then do your crosses out of, do your pieces out of them. So I like to do them freehand. One word of warning, this is where you guys want to be careful. You see, I started feeling around in that last piece there that I was cutting. You don't want to break them free in the middle. That's why I stopped, because I started to see where the joint holding those two together is actually getting very small. You want to go end to end when you start breaking them apart. So that's why I started doing that little feeling part, to let myself know, okay, you know, you're going to see that. That's marking, because that's how you take them apart, is you sit there and you make a bunch of little tiny plunge cuts very carefully and pick and poke at that. This big junk in here, you just kind of pick and poke at it, flip it, pick and poke at it, flip it. That's the other thing. If you want these to come out really even, even if you want to freehand it, flip it. Make your cuts go only a little bit in. Make your cuts all the way down. The more methodical you are with these, the more even everything's going to come out. I just want to get this shot. I don't know if you can see me here. I just want to get this shot. I think it's really cool. Part of the joy of being out here and doing stuff. I mean, there I have the sun in my video and it's not blinding out the whole video. Pretty sweet. Yeah, I'm just enjoying the day. You know, no matter physically how I'm feeling, whatever. You know, I told you my hurrying a bit because my back's bugging me. You know, so on and so forth. That's part of life. But enjoy what you're doing no matter how you feel. I guess that's what my message would be if there's a message to be had here. Other than that, it's just beautiful out. Nice day. Been waiting for this for a while, a nice day like this when I can just get out here and enjoy the weather in the day. All right, we'll continue. Okay, so at this point, you might notice I'm being gentle, because she's got flex, she's got a lot of flex to her. So what's happening is I weaken the entire structure of this thing because everything's held together with these little tiny points now. So there's where I would say, try to work it from one end to the other. As you're pulling them, getting them weaker, I get in a hurry. I kind of know what I'm doing sometimes. I've cracked these in half dozens of times, so it's nothing for me if I do it again, unfortunately. But yep, just be gentle with it and we'll carry on.
Oh.
There are some things in life that just make me so happy. There's just something so cool. I wish I could only do this kind of sculpture. It's so kinetic. It's so cool. I just can't say enough, you know, like how cool I think it really is. It's just wicked. I just took a whole log and broke it down into all these moving parts now. And There's nothing more satisfying than when you get those links apart. I mean, I like moving the thing around because it's so different every time you do something with it. I just love this, man. I such a work of art to me. I love the ability to be able to do this. I love the fact that I'm out here doing this. So that's where I'm going to say thank you, and we'll see you again in the near future. Maybe I'll have another cool project. I'm kind of hell-bent on this kinetic thing.